This is Azure This Week, and I'm David Tucker for a Cloud Guru. Listen, I know we're past Ignite, and you may have thought that things would slow down, but I can assure you that's not the case. I have a ton of announcements to discuss today that fall into the category of the team couldn't quite get these done before the big conference. We'll discuss static web apps. We'll hit on Cosmos DB. We'll even talk about multivariate anomaly detection, and trust me, that one will be perfect to bring up with all of your non-tech friends at that big holiday dinner party. Let's do it, let's get to the news. Oh, and if you want to always know about all of the amazing Azure news throughout the entire year, hit that subscribe button. Listen, I don't have just one or even two announcements for static web apps. I have six. So let's take a deep breath and dive in. First up, we have new platform support with Node 18 being supported in preview and with .NET 7 becoming generally available, which has some cool features like if you have a Blazor WebAssembly app, it will automatically build and deploy. Now, next up, we know that a ton of you use GitHub, but many organizations also use other repositories like GitLab and Bitbucket. Well, you'll be thrilled to know that support for both of these is now generally available. You can now use these as your CI/CD providers for static web apps. Check out the link in the description for more information on how to get started. Next, let's chat preview environments. These enable you to spin up a completely new environment when you have a pull request on your repository, and it will have a temporary URL generated for it. So you can now use these preview environments with Azure DevOps because that feature is now generally available. Now, in addition, you can now create named environments that are tied to specific branches. This will result in the same URL for the branch preview environment. This feature is now also generally available. And finally, you can now specify a setting for your app that enables you to skip the building of the API if you don't need it within your app. This one is now GA as well. Have you ever heard that the best things in life are free? Well, it's true. And one of those free things right up until the end of the year is certification prep. So whether you're a beginner or a seasoned pro, you can access free certification courses on a Cloud Guru or Pluralsight Skills taught by experts. You get weekly study guides with learning programs and resources all to help you prepare to get certified. One of those courses is the AZ900 Microsoft Azure Fundamentals, but there's also courses for AWS, Google Cloud, Terraform, or Kubernetes that will work well alongside your cloud certifications. So I'll drop a link in the description. Next up, we have two announcements for Cosmos DB. First up, you can now retry your writes when using MongoDB for Cosmos DB. Now, you've always been able to handle this with your own retry logic, but now you can take advantage of this at the driver level without any custom code required on your part. The good news is that this is generally available, but you'll need to enable this capability before it can be leveraged. So check out the notes in the description for instructions on how to get started with this. And also, you can now copy a Cosmos DB container within your account without having to leverage any extra tools to make it happen. So this can be critical if you're trying to test out some migrations, debug some data-specific issues, or even if you want to run analytics workloads without consuming any production capacity. Now, there are some caveats for this, so be sure to review the documentation from the link in the description before you take advantage of this public preview. Finally, instead of just relying on a single variable for anomaly detection with cognitive services, you can now leverage multivariate anomaly detection. So how many variables does this support? See, I can predict your questions here. The answer is up to 300, and this can give you insight into much more complex resources than were previously supported with the service. This feature is generally available. One last note here. I mentioned earlier that you should bring this up at your big holiday dinner party. In case the sarcasm didn't fully translate here in the video, let me tell you emphatically that you shouldn't do that. Part of our service here at A Cloud Guru is to give you a safe space to geek out whenever you want this holiday season without boring your second cousin or your significant other. That's my holiday gift to you. Wow, we're out of time already. I hope you enjoyed this smattering of post-Ignite Azure news as much as I did. Don't forget that Azure never stops, so you can come back next week for even more Azure announcements here on Azure This Week. Be sure to let us know if you have any comments below, and if you enjoyed this, hit the like and share it with others. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.